favorite song of the album.
Anybody glad to be here this morning? Anybody know it could have been the other way?
Good God Almighty, I tell you, God is good to us. He's good to us. He protects us through the storm and the rain. Amen. Don't you know every time lightning flashes, lightning is striking somewhere, when God let it bypass our home and our body, that's enough for me to say thank you. Oh, what a mighty God we serve. I came to lift him up. Anybody come to lift him up this morning? I know we few in number, but that's all right. That's all right. We can praise God while being few in number. Yeah, if you're going to be real about it. Yeah, if you're going to be real about it. Oh, you ought to give him glory this morning. We thank God for you. We thank God for each of you inside the sanctuary, each of you that are in the parking lot. We just thank God for you. Amen. Let us pray. This morning, our Heavenly Father, Lord, we come now just as humble as we know how to come. And Lord, we just want to say thank you. Oh, you're so good. You're so kind. You're so merciful to us. Fact of the matter is, dear God, you're better to us than we've been to our own self. You treat us better than we deserve to be treated. You love us so much, and I just want to say thank you. Lord, thank you that you brought us to the house of prayer one more time. It is so good to be in the service one more time, God. Lord, I pray that you would bless our worship on this morning. As I stand behind this sacred desk, I ask that you would speak through me now. Let your word fall on good soil, that it may spring up everlasting to everlasting life. Somebody will leave here today a much better person and Christian than they were when they came. Only because of you. We love you so much, we do lift you up, and we will forever magnify your holy name. For it's in Jesus' name we ask it all. For his sake we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And amen.
Amen.
We certainly give honor to God, who is my life. It is through him that we live, we move, and have our beings. We give honor to Jesus the Christ, who is and always will be the great head of the church. Give honor to the Holy Spirit, who is my comforter and my guide. Give honor to Elder Evans, Minister Bradley, our other Minister Bradley, Minister Williams, to our Mother Board, to our very powerful deacon staff, to each of you, all of my Father's children, all of you inside the sanctuary, and each of you that are in the parking lot. We give honor to you, and we certainly give honor to my own family, especially my very lovely wife, whom I thank God for every single day of my life. Amen. There is a word from the Lord. And I think I ought to tell you, there's a very serious word from the Lord. It's a word that I'm glad you're here this morning, because we all need it. This word this morning. Amen. If you brought your Bibles, we want you to turn with us to the Gospel according to Matthew. The Gospel according to St. Matthew. We want to go to chapter 7. And we want to zoom in and focus on three verses this morning. Amen. Amen. We want to focus on three verses this morning. Matthew chapter 7. It's going to be verses 21 through 23. This is a very serious lesson, and my heart was truly heavy as I studied it and as God revealed things to me concerning this lesson. St. Matthew chapter 7, verses 21 through 23. When you find it, I'm certain you'll find these words recorded. Not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but
he that doeth the will of my Father which is in heaven. Many, did y'all hear me? Many will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name? And in thy name have cast out devils, and in thy name done many wonderful works. And then will I profess unto them. This is Jesus talking, y'all. And then will I profess unto them, I never knew you. Depart from me, ye that work iniquity. My Lord. We like to offer for a subject taken from these passages and other supporting passages of scriptures. You better stop pretending. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. You better stop pretending. You better stop pretending. All over the world, you have people talking a good game, but they ain't doing nothing they talking about. They say black lives matter, but they still killing black folk. They say we ought to stick together, but they want you to support them, but they don't support nothing you do. They say, I know I'm going to heaven when I die, but they still living a life full of sin. You better stop pretending. There's a lot of pretending going on, I tell you. Folks pretending to be preachers. Look like a preacher, talk like a preacher, but their lifestyle don't match what they say. Folks pretending to be a police officer. They even have the flashing blue lights. They even have went somewhere and bought police uniforms. But they only pretending. Folks pretending to be nice and kind to you. But as soon as you let them in your home or in your car or in your life, they try to destroy you. They just pretending. And folks even pretending that they love you when they know they can't stand you. You better stop all that pretending. A lot of folks profess, but they don't possess. They don't have it. They profess with their mouth, but they don't possess it in their heart. They don't have what they say they have. They don't live like they say they live. But one day, church, we're going to have to put our money where our mouth is. One day, we all going to be tried in the fire. God has given me this sermon today for a reason. He doesn't want anybody here to end up like the many that we talked about in the scripture. Yeah. But some people gonna end up like the many. I already know because some people have studied the life of a Christian. They've studied the life of a Christian so long that they know how to walk like a Christian on Sunday morning. they change their walk on Sunday. But if you see them on Monday, it's a different swagger to them. Oh, my. Yeah, they study the life of a Christian so much that they even know the vocabulary of a Christian. They know the things to say. That Christians are always saying. But so many are going to end up in hell. I told you this is a serious message this morning. But listen, while the blood is running warm in your vein, while you still have time to get your life together. God wants you to stop pretending that you have a close walk with him. You see, you don't really have to pretend you have a close walk with the Lord. You can really have a closer walk with him. You can do it. But I think I want to tell you something, church. Yeah. Right now, you can really get to know the Lord, and he can really get to know you. Right now, this day, you can get to know the Lord, and he can get to know you. I hear what somebody saying. I heard you. You thought I didn't hear you, but I heard what somebody said. I thought God knew everybody. Well, he does. He made each of us. So as a human being, he does know who you are. But can I tell you, flesh and blood won't enter into heaven. He don't know you spiritually. God Almighty. As a child of God, if you have never come to him for personal salvation, if you've never come to Christ for salvation, if you never accepted his son as your Lord and Savior, if you never surrendered your life to him, he doesn't know you in a spiritual way. He just don't know you like that. Yeah, which explains to me why you're still struggling so much. God don't know you. Which explains to me why you can't seem to make ends meet. God don't know you. Which explains to me, good God Almighty, why when you pray to the Lord, you say he don't never answer my prayer. God don't know you. Good God Almighty. Bible said that he's going to declare, I never knew you. My Lord. Somebody want to know, is that Jesus talking? Is that the man that loves everybody? Is that him that's saying that I never knew you? Yeah, it's him. It's him. And let me tell you why it's him. Because we were on our way to hell. Yes. We didn't have a God on our side. Yes, sir. We were doomed to die. We had no hope, no right to the tree of life because of our sin. But God said, I love the world so much, I'm going to send my only begotten son to die on the Calvary for the sins of the world. And God said, now, I'm going to let mankind come to heaven on one condition. You got to do my will. You got to accept my son as your Lord and Savior. So when you don't accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, Jesus is saying, I never knew you. I never knew you. See, his dying is not in vain. And God ain't gonna let nobody come to heaven and live an eternal life where the streets are paved with gold if you don't accept his son.
That's right.
So yeah, this is Jesus talking. And he means every word that he's saying. I hate to see people gambling. I just hate to see folks gambling. You know what gambling means? It means to bet on an uncertain outcome, to take a chance. You're not sure if you're going to win or lose when you gamble. And most of the time when you gamble, what happens? You lose. A true gambling man knows when to hold him and when to fold him. He's so good at pretending that he makes you think he possesses something when he knows he really don't have what he say he got. He ain't got it, but he'll make you think he got it. But church, I got a news flash for you this morning. Your eternal life is not to be gambled with. No, your salvation is not to be gambled with. You must be sure that you not only profess, but you also must be sure you possess eternal life. And yeah, you can be sure. You can be sure. Folks will tell you, well, you don't know if you're going to heaven or not. You don't know. But you can know. You can know if you believe the word of God. The scripture says that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in thine heart that God raised him from the dead, thou shalt what?
Be saved.
Yeah, that's the word. That's the word. But it's more than just talking about it. It's more than just professing it. You got to possess it. When you say, I believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, you got to show some signs. Good God Almighty. Yeah, let's look at the text this morning. And I think I ought to tell you that if you are a pretender, you're treading on thin ice. If you're a pretender now, and only you know if you're pretending or not, you and God, that is. Yeah, yeah. But it ain't going to end well for you if you're a pretender, because you can't fool God. And it's a shame to walk around this world all your life pretending, trying to fool folk. And then when your life comes to an end, Jesus had to tell you, depart from me. I never knew you. You workers of iniquity. Good God Almighty. This lesson is serious, ain't it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. This thing called life is real. It represents heaven. And this thing called death is real. It represents hell. And when it's all over down here, we're going to spend eternity in one of those places. And if heaven is your goal, you better start pretending and get real with the Lord. But can I tell you this? Because I just believe that if there's no pretenders in here, I believe that you know some pretenders. And I want you to be able to share the word with them. Don't feel rained on or ashamed if you are a pretender. Because every blood-washed believer didn't know God at first. Yeah. We didn't know him at first. Paul said in Ephesians chapter 2, verses 3 through 5, he said, among whom also we all had our conversations in time past in the lust of our flesh. Paul said we all, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind. And he said we were by nature the children of wrath, even as others. We were just like everybody else. So you ain't got to feel rained on if you're a pretender. You don't have to be a pretender no more. And you don't have to think that you're the only one. We all have been there. We all were in Satan's cages at one time. Everybody here, I don't care how holy, how sanctified you look, everybody here at one time in your life was in Satan's cage. He had you at one time. But God, who is rich in mercy, for his great love wherewith he loved us, even when we were dead in sins, have quickened us together with Christ. And by grace, we are saved. Ain't the Lord all right? My point is, nobody here can point the finger at you when you admit that you have not been living the life that you've been pretending to live. Can't nobody else point the finger at you? Because we all, at some point in our life, we did the same thing, and I just believe in keeping it real.
That's right.
You know, and that's another thing that's wrong with our children. Our parents ain't keeping it real with the children. Our children go out there and they make a mistake. You find out that they've been smoking dope. You find out that they've done something they ain't supposed to have done. Daughter might get pregnant. you go off. You want to beat the child down because he got caught smoking dope. But you never tell him you used to smoke dope too. You ain't going to keep it real with him, are you? Some of these little children, when the mothers go off on them because they get pregnant at a young age, all they got to do is look at the birth certificate. Find out when they were born. They might find out that they were born and you weren't even married. Stop acting like you so holy when other folks mess up. You ain't holy like that. You ain't always been like that. We got to keep it real. Jesus here in our text is keeping it real. He's bringing his Sermon on the Mount. This was a Sermon on the Mount, starting in chapter 5, and now we're in chapter 7. And Jesus is bringing this sermon to an end, and he brings it to a very serious end. He's not sugarcoating this gospel at all. And you know Jesus is very serious when he tells us that everybody ain't going to make it into heaven. That's serious talk, yeah. You might not want to listen to me, but these words flowed off the lips of Jesus. And you ought to listen to Jesus if you want to hear me. In verse 21, Jesus said, "Not everyone that said unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father which is in heaven." Those are the ones that's going to make it in. And this is what I know, church. This is what I know. Some people are just a fan of Jesus. Some folks just a fan. You know how you're a fan of Michael Jordan, or Kobe Bryant, or Steph Curry? You're just a fan. And some folks is just a fan of Jesus Christ. They're a big supporter of Jesus. Oh, yeah, they support him now. But they really don't know him. They love talking about him. They love to cheer him on. They be talking about, look at God. They know they don't know him. They be talking about, go ahead, Jesus. No, they don't know him. And then they got the nerve to say, God got me. They keep up with all his records. They know all about Jesus. They can tell you. They'll tell you, I know he ain't never lost a case. Won't they tell you that? Yeah, but when they get in trouble, they won't even trust him. They'll tell you he never lost a patient. But as soon as they get sick, they won't depend on him. Some folks know all of Jesus' stats. They pretending, y'all. They just pretenders. They know his stats. They'll tell you, he fed 5,000. Didn't have but 2 fish and 5 loaves of bread. They keep up with the stats on Jesus. They'll tell you, he raised folks from the dead. He raised Lazarus and the widow woman's son. They'll tell you, I keep up with what he's doing. They'll tell you how many lepers he healed at one time. They know about it. Yeah. And church, that's all good, but you know what's really sad? All that what I just mentioned is hearsay. They wasn't there. They wasn't there when he healed the leper. They wasn't there when he raised the dead. They wasn't there when he fed the 5,000. So you really don't know Jesus, and he really don't know you until you give your life to him. And when he lives inside of you, that's when you really get to know the Lord. Yeah, then the records that you keep up with don't have to be about Jesus and the folks in the Bible. Then you can start keeping up with the records that he's winning for you. Yeah, you'll be able to tell the world how many times he healed your body. You'll be able to tell the world how many times he took the pain away from you. You'll be able to keep up with his stats. You'll be able to to tell the world how many times he made a way when there was no way for him. Has he ever made a way for anybody when you thought there was no way? Yeah. You can start telling the world how he fed your family when you didn't know how you was going to get your next meal. You can tell the world how he took a little and made a lot. Oh, I know the Lord is all right. Yeah, you can start telling the world how he provides for you and your family when you got more bills than you got money. Yeah. Listen, church, I think I ought to tell you, Jesus don't want to be our idol. That ain't what he wants. He don't want to be our idol. He don't want to just to be a fan, treat him like he's a fan. That ain't what he wants. Jesus wants to be our friend. And he wants to be a friend that'll stick closer than any brother. Yeah, he wants us to have a personal relationship with him. He wants us to be able to tell people with confidence, I tried it for myself. And I know what my God can do. You ain't got to go by the stats that's in the Bible. You may be able to tell him, I tried it for myself. Anybody ever tried? God Almighty. Yeah, I think I want to tell you that once you experience the power of God for yourself, that's when the whole Bible becomes real in your life. When you experience what God can do for you, you ain't got no trouble believing that he parted the Red Sea and folks walked across on dry land. But now, when you ain't never experienced nothing for yourself, you got a problem believing that. I don't care what you say. You got a problem believing that. You got a problem believing that he spit on the ground and touched a man's eye and a man was able to see. If he ain't never healed your body, you got a problem believing he healed anybody. Good God Almighty. But when he healed your body, you ain't got no problem saying, I know what the Lord can do. Notice verse number 21 again. Jesus makes a difference between the ones who say and the ones who do. And church, getting into heaven is going to take more than just talking about it. And you must walk the walk, and you must do the master's will. This is a very serious sermon. And listen, and if I don't make it plain enough, God won't be pleased with me. Because I got an assignment from the Lord. Every Sunday morning that I come here and preach, if I don't touch your heart enough to make you know that you need the Lord when you walk out these doors, I have not done my job. When you leave here, you ought to leave here knowing that you can't make it by yourself. So here it is, church. Here it is. I'm going to make it very plain. All those good deeds you do, all those times you show up for church every time the door opens, all that money you pay in church, all that religious talk you do, all them bumper stickers with the fish on the back, all every time somebody finna get in your car, you turn to 95.5, all that stuff you do, that ain't gonna get it, brother. That ain't gonna get it. None of that gonna get you into heaven. Just because you know how to say, Lord, Lord, don't mean Jesus hear your prayer. Just because you know how to quote scriptures, don't mean Jesus hear your prayer. Especially when the same mouth that quotes scriptures on Sunday morning, the same mouth that prays God on Sunday morning, is the same mouth that you use to cuss folks out on Monday morning on your job. There's something wrong with that pitch, I tell you. You just ain't gonna make it into heaven, especially when the same body that you used to walk for Jesus on Sunday, you used it last night on the dance floor for Satan. Y'all know what I'm talking about. On Sunday, they walk holy and sanctified. Oh, they walk holy, y'all. Oh, you can't tell them they ain't saved. But last night at the club, they moved on the dance floor like they back ain't got no bone. You ain't gonna make it to heaven like that, I tell you. You need to stop all that pretending. see you in heaven. Pastor Lazy, I got a question for you. Okay, what's the question? Just who will make it into heaven? The answer is given by Jesus. He says, some will, y'all. But not everyone that says, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven. Some of us gonna make it, but not everybody. Just because you can call his name, that don't mean everybody gonna make it in there. The church, in this text, we have two kinds of people. We have those that like to work alone and don't include Jesus in nothing they do. We have in that same group of folk there, this is still the first kind of people, that they profess, but they do very little of anything else. Most of all they do is run off at the mouth. A lot of talk, but ain't no action in nothing they say. Y'all know some folk like that, don't you? Don't look at them. They might be sitting beside you. Don't look at them. But y'all know some folk like that. Number two, you got another kind of folk. You got the folks that possess Christ. We got Christ. We possess him. We got him. We have Christ in our heart and in our life. And you're doing a great work for the Lord in the church and out of the church. You're doing a great work for the Lord when folks looking at you and when they're not looking at you. That's the other kind of folk we have out there. Those that possess Christ, they keep their minds stayed on Jesus. Those that possess Christ are very sincere. They call him Lord, Lord, knowing that he will come and see about it. They have a good prayer life. They have a good witnessing life. They know how to love and to forgive.
Yes, sir.
Oh, yeah. If you possess Christ, not only do you know how to love, but you also know how to forgive. Yeah. Yeah. They get involved with church activities for the right reason. Some folks get involved with it for the wrong reason. Some folks get involved with church activity. They want to get out there and stir up some mess.
That's right.
But this group of people I'm talking about, the ones that possess Christ, they are the real deal. They're not pretenders. Look at verse number 22. Jesus is still talking, y'all. In verse number 22, he said, many, which means a whole lot of folk, will say unto me, Jesus said, they're going to say it to me. He said, they're going to say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name? And in thy name have cast out devils. We prophesied, Lord. We cast out devils in your name. We've done many wonderful works. But the problem Jesus had with those pretenders was this. Maybe they did all of those things. But Jesus is telling them, you did it all for the wrong reason. You wanted the glory for yourself. You were self-centered. You did it for the money. When folks ask you to preach revival, first thing you want to know is how much you're going to pay me. You did it for fame. You did it for a show. Jesus saying you did it because you wanted a pat on the back. Jesus said, you never acknowledged me before you preached or sung a song. You had confidence in yourself and not in me. Jesus said, you wanted people to look on you. They pleaded their case. Y'all ought to have been there. These pretenders pleaded their case with Jesus. And Jesus is saying to them, yes, you had gifts, but you didn't use them for my glory. You never drew near to me. He said, I saw you, but I never knew you. He said, I saw you, but I never knew you. God Almighty. You can see folks doing great things out there. You can see LeBron James breaking records out there. You can see him, but you never knew him. You don't know that man. Like you know him. You don't know LeBron. That's what Jesus is going to say to us. I saw you, but I never knew you. Church, can you imagine standing before Christ at the judgment bar, standing before the great I am, standing before God Almighty, the supreme being, and you trying to claim that the stuff you did give you a right to make it into heaven. Can you imagine that? You standing before Jesus at the judgment bar, and you trying to run down your list talking about stuff you done done. You ain't done nothing. It don't work like that, children. Isaiah 64:6 says, but we are all as unclean things. In all our righteousness. Why are you trying to run down the list on stuff you've done? It said all our righteousness are as filthy rags. And we all do fade as a leaf. And our iniquities like the wind have taken us away. Then when you look at Mark 7:6, Jesus said, where has Isaiah prophesied of you hypocrites? As it is written, this people, talking about the pretenders, this people honored me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. My Lord. Church, if you're going to make it into heaven, you must get Jesus way down in your heart. You got to get him in your soul. You got to get real and stop all that faking and shaking. Titus 1:16 says, they profess that they know God, but in their works they deny him, being abominable and disobedient and unto every good work reprobate. Church, do y'all know what separates the real Christians from the pretenders? Love. Love makes the difference. You can't fake love. No, you can't fake love. People know when you love them and when you don't. You can just use that word loosely if you want to. Telling folks I love you. They know when you love them and when you don't. They already know. You can't fake it now. 1 John 3:18 said, my little children, let us not love in word, neither in tongue, but in deed and in truth. We gotta let it be real. I have a message for all the pretenders, and I'm trying to get out of here, but I have a message for all the pretenders. You ought to be glad that you're still alive and the dirt have not covered you up yet. Why, Lacey? Because Jesus is letting you in on the future. He's telling you that you got time. He's telling you he's going to be the future judge. He's telling you, I'm going to be the future judge. And he's telling you exactly how the case is going to go. He's telling you how the case is going to end up if you don't change right now. Jesus said, many shall say unto me in that day, Lord, Lord, I've been working for you. Verse 22, they made three strong arguments. Yeah, these pretenders, they had a case. They thought they had a case. They made three strong arguments. And this is what they said first. They said, we deserve to get into heaven because we prophesied in Jesus' name. That was their first case, their first argument. Then they said, we deserve to get into heaven because we cast out devils in your name. And the third argument they had, they said, we did great work in Jesus' name. But I can remember what Romans 10:3 said. For they being ignorant of God's righteousness and going about to establish their own righteousness have not submitted themselves unto the righteousness of God. Remember this, church. When you do things in life, no matter how great your accomplishments are, if you don't give God the glory, he's not in it and he don't know you. As I hurry on to a close now, every time I read and study verse 23, my heart really gets heavy. Because Jesus is not a man that he should lie, neither the son of man that he should repent. Hath he said, and shall he not do it? Whatever he says is going to happen. Or has he spoken, and shall he not make it good? Whatever he said, it's going to happen just like he said. In other words, when I look at verse 23, I already know that some pretenders ain't gonna make it into heaven.
Yes, sir.
A lot of folk gonna be in the same boat. The judgment is gonna be in public. Many gonna be pleading at the same time. Lord, didn't we do this for you? But if you stop pretending, you won't have to hear him say these words. I never knew you. Depart from me, ye that work iniquity. If you only stop pretending today and accept Christ as your Lord and Savior, you too can make it into heaven. This message brings tears to my eyes. I really feel sorry for the ones who refuse to stop pretending. The ones who continue to say one thing, but they do another. The ones who think they're going to heaven anyhow. Jesus said the pretenders gonna be bound hand and feet. They're gonna be taken away and cast into outer darkness. They're gonna be weeping and gnashing of teeth. You ought to get on board this old ship of Zion. It has landed many of thousands. Good morning, Randy. If you don't see me no more, I stopped by. I'm on my way to glory. But I had to tell you, if you want to make it into heaven, you can't be a pretender. Everything you do for my master, you got to let it be real. If you're going to sing, let it be real. If you're going to pray, you ought to let it be real. If you're going to shout, you ought to let it be real. If you're going to teach, you ought to let it be real. If you're going to preach, you ought to let it be real. God is, he's tired of folk pretending that you know him. He's tired of folk pretending that you love him. Good God Almighty, here, you ought to get to know the Lord for yourself. I found out to know him is to love him. Anybody here love him? Ain't he all right this morning? Anybody here glad that you know the Lord for your own self? I'm talking about Jesus, that man from Galilee. Anybody here know him? That stone that's hewed out the mountain, that meek and humble lamb. This ain't no time for pretending. Jesus is, he's on his way back. I wonder, will you be ready? Will you be ready when the master come back? He's coming back for a church without a spot or a wrinkle. Anybody here know him? Anybody gonna be ready to make it into heaven? Heaven is a prepared place for prepared people. Just anybody ain't going in there. Everybody talking about heaven, sure ain't going there. Many gonna say, Lord, Lord, I prophesied in your name. Many gonna say, oh, I heal the sick in your name. Many gonna say, I cast out devils in your name. But Jesus said, I'm gonna tell them, depart from me. I never knew you. Stop pretending. Stop pretending. Let it be real. I'm on my way to glory. I want to see you there. I want to see you there. But you can't go around here pretending. The doors of the church is open. Jesus died for us so we wouldn't have to pretend. Jesus died for us that we'll have a right to the tree of life. Don't you know they whipped him all night long for you and I? Don't you know they pierced him in the side? Don't you know they hung him on an old rugged cross just so we wouldn't have to pretend? He died, but early the third day morning. He got up. Preacher, he got up. With all power. All power in his hand. Stop pretending. Stop pretending. Doors of the church is open. Will there be one? Might not know the Lord in the party. He died for you and for me. I pray that we all be ready. Y'all just don't know how sad I'm going to be when I get there, because I know I'm going. But you don't know how sad I'm going to be when I start looking for the sheep that God gave me. But I'm going to be so sad if Jesus had to tell me, Lacey, you did all you could do, but you had some pretenders in the church. I had to tell them to depart from it. I never knew. You ain't got to pretend no more. If you don't know the Lord in the pardon of your sins, you ought to give your life to him today. If you die in your sins, in hell, you're going to lift up your eyes. It ain't nothing mom and daddy can do. Ain't nothing the preacher can do. Jesus is going to have the last word. He said he's going to say to the servant, all those pretenders, he said, go and bind them. Because he's coming back. He's coming back. I pray we all be ready. I pray for you every day, every night. I don't want to see you lost. Church right in the middle of Bass Pro Shop last week. I was looking at Fisher Lewis and he was looking at him. And he said, brother, I hope that folks is ready for heaven. He said, because if they don't know how to praise him down here, they're going to have a hard time up in heaven. We better learn how to praise him right here. We got to get ready for his return. We got to get ready, children. Get our business straight. So we can all be there together. Ready. We got to be ready.